aware as Christians right now. But the devil really roaming. He to and fro. You understand? So tonight, when I say be aware, my first point is that, not the point, but the first thing is the coronavirus. If we watch right now, this coronavirus is a trick of the enemy. And one of his main points of this coronavirus is to keep us from worshiping God. So one of his devices right now is to keep us not worshiping God. Because as I come in, that pastor mentioned, you know, long time you come to church, you never had to watch no time. Right now they're limiting us to a specific time. They're telling me we have only 90 minutes to congregate. So we knowing that is a plan of the enemy. So tonight, the young converts among us, don't get weary. Don't get weary. Hold faith, because you know you're now coming to this Christian life, and as you're coming to this life now, look what approaching we. A pandemic, where we can't really gather together. Look, if you're watching it, you have social distancing. This is not a plan of God. This is a plan of the enemy. So I say tonight, as young Christians, as Christian believers, let me rise up. Let me rise up. We were called to pray. You understand? We were called to pray. So we had to really rise up above this thing. Because now, when what will happen is that the whole shot, they don't want us to be here. You understand? When I was in the media briefing, let me say this week here, pass on, but what ahead next week? We don't know. The next media briefing could be there by shutting down the church. But remember, if they shut down the church, they can't shut down Jesus. We have Jesus in our heart, and we will continue to serve him in spirit and in truth. We're supposed to be serving Christ. And they don't want us to serve Christ, so tonight we're coming to serve Christ in your own heart. You understand? We can't give up. We cannot give up. They're aiming for we not to pray, but we are to pray. So, brethren and sisters, tonight in the house of the Lord, or just remember the word that if they shut that church down, they can't shut Jesus down. And we have to be with one another. So, in your heart, you have to have Jesus in your heart. You have to throw Jesus in your heart and go forth in the name of Jesus, because this is the time. He said, forsake not the assembling of the brethren, ever the morning is the day approaching, and that day approaching so quick. And what have been weary we of, even Christians, believers, getting weary of, because why? They're telling themselves, well, now my God, like, he ain't coming true for me, but God is on that throne. He's still working. He's the Hebrews 38. God is that same God. He never gave up on me. We giving up on him. You understand? So we are called to pray. So we can't afford to relax ourselves. Because the enemy ain't relaxing you. Right now we're going with a certain speed.
That's it.
And when you want the speed that we're moving in, it's to shut me down. And for you to continue to go. If you want really and truly, you don't want to shut down no band, beacon. The whole aim is to shut the church down. But tonight, when I watch at the gathering tonight, we are called. And I'm glad to see that, you know, we could still come out and be in numbers.
Yes, yes.
You understand, despite all that is going on, we could come forth and worship God.
Yes.
And if you watch right now where I am, behind the pulpit, I have a limited time. So I can't really go into the world. When pastor comes, you have a limited time. Worship, I have a limited, everybody is limiting we. The God that we serve, you know, limit we could go on and pray. But they, so you know it, this coronavirus is a part of the enemy.
That's it.
You understand? It is a part and a plan of the enemy. So, as I move forward again, when you watch Christians today, my next point is laziness.
Right.
As Christians, we're getting too lazy. Now, the pandemic has taken place, but when you watch, we're getting too lazy. We lay back too much. You understand? Too much of the time, we sit back. I don't want to go to church today, I don't want to go here, I don't want, but every other thing else that we're doing. You understand? For example, I sit down home just recently, and my wife within the Netflix, so it have a movie on the TV. So I sit down and I watch the movie, but I realize the series is nice. So within I watch the movie, the series was so nice. You wouldn't believe I sit down in front of that TV for 4 hours. And don't even realize, so the enemy don't even want you to know that time going by, that you should pray and then pray. So I sit down and I'm watching this thing, and then after that, I say, wait now. I should be praying and I'm watching this movie. Just yesterday or the day before yesterday, she come and she put it on. She said, where is ready with that? I said, well, let me watch. When she watched one series, she said, ready, let me take off that thing, let me go and pray. So I'll take 10 minutes here. I said, but I laugh within my mind when she said, we want to pray, because when we went to pray, we got a word from God. So many a time laziness caused me not to hear from God, because we want to hear from a movie. And the Lord laid in my heart that we given these things power over us, because everything in your house that is of the devil device is controlled by power. The TV is controlled power. So when you put on the TV and you give the TV power over you, when you put on your phone, you press the power over you. Why not get the power of the Holy Spirit and go into the world and read and meditate and continue to pray? We are called to pray, and laziness taking hold of us. Many times you wake up and you say, when I now get saved, my knees were black, black, black. Now I find my knees getting clear. So I know something going on wrong there already. Because I'm waking up now the Holy Spirit, I'm accustomed, let me say, waking up every morning 2 o'clock, it will continue to do that. But you who are stubborn will not continue to pray. So I wake up 2 o'clock, and I lie down there sometimes, I toss and I turn, 2 o'clock I ain't gone ready yet. You understand? So the time that we are called to pray, laziness is taking over the church. And if you want to even in the church, if you want the seats tonight, you see that laziness taking me over, because we tell him, we say, boy, I'm going to go in prayer meeting tonight, or I'm going to go in Bible study, but every word of God is relevant to today. And we need to be hearing, we need to be, what pastor preach, yes, we hear, but we had to have a relationship with God too. On our own, we're supposed to have a one-on-one relationship with God. We're supposed to be praying, we're supposed to be in a position where we know how to pray. I just say, pray, we pray. But that laziness crawling upon me. You understand? Plenty times that laziness, right now I tell you, I'm guilty too. Because my knees get there. So which means I'm not going on the knees as often as I used to be when I now get saved. When you now get saved, you don't have a, when you don't have a, I'm just to serve God. But then as pastor teach you, it comes like when you now marry that reception and everything nice, and after 2-3 years down the road, you get a cardiacal. So right now I find I get a cardiacal, but I thank God that, you know, he could still use me and bring many hopes of the Lord and continue to worship him. You understand? So if the young believers tonight, be aware. This is the message he's wanted to be aware. And I'll have to move on quick. I can't wait because of the time. So, brotherly love. We're missing it. We're missing brotherly love. We're missing that in the house. We're missing brotherly love. You know, as I bring out Wednesday on about that same topic closely, but that brotherly love, we're missing that. In the long time church, you know, Pastor now touch on it again. Pastor, like, you know how I was coming to sit tonight. That in China, when they see 10, they're anxious. They're ready to pray. They're feeling happy because they see 10 there. You understand? But with we, that brotherly love not there. That brotherly love not there. We need to get back to that place where that brotherly love, where we can call each other. That way they give us room, they give it what I the same device. We could use it for good. We could use it to text our brother, text our sister, how you're going, blessings, love. But instead of that, we're using it to, well, I want to go into it. But we're using it for the wrong purpose. So tonight my message is, be aware of the devil's devices. It has plenty of devices that this enemy is using. I tell you, they're moving quick. He's moving very, very, very quick. So we have to continue to pray and to gather together. So if next week when I shut down the church, always remember in your heart you had a relationship with Christ Jesus. So don't forget that you will always have to pray, and don't get lazy and say, boy, I done this thing and I'm walking away from Christianity. I am lying. Since I get saved from Rastafari to Jesus Christ, I did the happiest I ever lived in my life, and I could testify anywhere in the world I go. Jesus Christ is real.
Amen.
He is real.
Hallelujah.
He is real. Everything of Jesus is real. I can testify it over and over and over. The amount of pressure and pain I go through. That is what I didn't know. The devil's devices. So I was using his tools all the time. But now Jesus gave me new tools. New tools.
Hallelujah.
The tools that I carry now. Look, I can carry a mic and pick up the name of Jesus. I'm using good tools. I ain't using the tools that I used to pull. I'm using the tools that I could send a message for. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior. And I stand so tonight, as I will have to close, because I can't go longer. You see the devil done busting shut already? The time gone. And Pastor. The time already going fast. Because you may abide with their law. They want to, you know, they want to do things that they right. But in the name of Jesus, brethren and sister, I encourage each and every one here tonight and who outside, we encourage them. This is the place to be, 2021 and beyond, forever and ever. This is the place to be in the house of the Lord and giving Jesus a good shout and blessing of the name. This is where we ought to be and continue to pray without ceasing.
Yes.
Always remember, let's continue to pray, because this is what we have to do. When everything going bad and everything, prayer is what we have. That is we weapon. That is we weapon. We weapon is prayer. So we are to continue to pray. So as I close tonight, I thank God for the opportunity that I get to come tonight, Pastor. Thank you again too. And to everyone, I bless. Pray God that will bless all of you. And I hope everybody enjoy the rest of the night. In Jesus' name.
Come on,
give him praise.
Hallelujah!
Peter stepped out. And tonight, you know, we often say that Peter stepped out the boat and he walked on water. I want to trouble you a little bit tonight, you know. And I want to tell you rather that Peter stepped out of one boat and stepped into another boat. You say, Pastor, what do you mean by that? You know, what I want to help you understand tonight is that the word is your boat. Glory to God. And what I gain tonight, and I want you to stretch your Holy Ghost imagination and understand where I'm coming from. The word of God is your boat. As I sat at home today and I meditated on this, I realized that the word of God keeps you afloat. I understand that the word of God prevents you from sinking, church. I realize that the word of God is what causes you to move closer to Jesus. I realize that the word of God empowers you to begin to do the same kinds of things Jesus is doing. I realize the word is about when Peter stepped out, glory to Jesus. It still didn't have time to touch the water because Peter was standing on the word. And you need to understand that it is the power of the word come. What word you hear from God? Whatever word you heard from God, once you add your faith to that word is going to empower you to be supernatural. The word that Peter received and heard, that one word, Matthew 14:29, come. That word, it became Peter's boat. That is what, and Peter's faith and obedience to that is what caused Peter to stay afloat. And that is an illustration and an analogy of what we can apply to daily living. We need to understand in a season of corona that is checking you on the side, listen, Christian don't take needle. Because we have, hallelujah, a boat that is able to keep us afloat, never to sink. And not only that, when Jesus said, come, and the man responded to the word in faith, the man began to move closer to Christ. I want you to get a message in that message. It is the word that brings you closer to Jesus. And I realize, as much as the word brings you closer to him, the word ends up making you more like him. Because in the process of moving closer to Jesus, the man started resenting Jesus. Because when the other 11 guys in that boat look, not only did they see, they didn't only see one man walking, but they see two men walking on water. This is amazing how they work to transform your life into the symptoms of the length of his hair, the color of his eyes, or his height, but to begin to resemble Jesus in your actual behavior and in your demonstrations, church. But it's not automatic. The word work for it is automatic. I realize that the word work, when you work it, don't tell him and say, work it. I realize the word work when you work it. So I realize that you have to both believe it and then apply it. So then there's a message I can message. Jesus said, go to the night, come.
What did Peter do?
I tell you, let me tell you something. Faith is 99%. Believe in Jesus, but listen, 1%. It requires something. It requires something. Now, you might be a believer in Christ and you're coming out of our background. Can anybody testify tonight that many times fear before you came to know Christ, you struggle with fear, and since coming to know Christ, you still struggle with fear. Not that you don't believe Jesus and don't believe what he says, but you have this fear haunting you. And I realize that I'm not going to have faith, but there is something called fear that is haunting you and have a negative effect upon your faith. And listen to me.
I went to my mom one time, she told me she understood to Joyce Meyer. She said she went after a funeral interview, but she said, Alan, I spoke on the mic. She had a little call. I said, Mommy, well done. She said, yes, I adjust the crowd. Glory to God. I said, it wasn't much. She said, boy, I was frightened like everything. I said, so what? She said, she listened to Joyce Meyer teach her series called Do It Afraid. Glory to God. Amen. Because you know, tell me something. I realize that this is because you have faith. I don't mean that you wouldn't feel the butterflies in your belly, and you wouldn't feel your knees buckling, and you wouldn't feel your heart over racing. Glory to God. But you have to understand something, you know. There comes a time when, after a while, trusting God and believing God, you have to get fed up of allowing fear to keep you back and do it afraid. Even if you feel the butterflies in your feet, your heart racing, get up and do it. Amen. So Peter step out in faith, but listen to me. Peter was afraid, I am sure. But you have to be able. Do it afraid, in faith. Just go forth in the name of Jesus' name. And Peter, step out. So I am saying to you that you have to be reading the word. But you have to apply the word, or else without application, you ain't going to see nothing. So when you're dealing with God and you want to see results from God, it's not about believing and waiting. It's about believing and doing. Are you understanding, church? You have to be able to get out and step out of that boat. Glory to Jesus. And I realize what I like about the word. Listen, the word is your book. And what I like about the word is that the word works anyway. The word don't need a conducive circumstances for it to work. You know something, you might buy a plant to tell you, don't use the same water. Are you with me? You might buy a toy to tell you, don't let it get wet. Amen. You might buy an automatic plane, one of them drones, you know, tell you, don't fly it in high wind. But here what I like about the word. That the worst is circumstances, the better you will seem to work. So glory to God, Jesus said, come. And just tell yourself, well, if the seas were quiet and calm, that instruction will work better. But listen, why let about the word and the word? For it will work for you. It don't depend on external circumstances. It doesn't matter what's going on around you. All that matters is who spoke to you, your God, and what you have in your faith in him. And regardless of what circumstances is in you, that the word can work for you in Jesus' mighty name. Listen, the word work in the sea. And that same word work in the wilderness when Jesus was tempted by the devil. So whether you don't feel or run, the word of God is work. The word work against devils and it work against disease. Jesus said, get the end, Satan. And he said, when a man with a man, shut up. Glory to God. You ain't saying nothing, church. Glory to God. They work good. And what the fuck, the word work against man and work against sheep. Jesus said, "Thou victory never again shall a man eat you the tree with her." I am saying to you, listen, in any circumstances, to anybody, in any place, no matter what the word of God always will give Jesus Christ a good note of praise tonight. Hallelujah! Glory to Jesus. So the conclusion I make, I'm going to tell you something. When you put all of that together, when they begin to understand that the worse the circumstances, the worse works, the better. Man, listen, church, you never feel of corona.
Yes. I am not concerned about what corona doing. I concerned about what the word of God can do. Yes. Talk to me, church. I want to let the air attention more to hear from God and to hear from press conferences, from CNN News or TV6. amen, and respond to Jesus. Did Jesus say, come? Are you with me? You get to determine the quality of the Christian walk. You get to determine if you succumb to the storm or if you walk to the storm. You get to determine whether you rely on the boat and play dead, or whether you will challenge the forces of nature and gravity, challenge the impossible, and say, I, in spite of the wind, I get it on this boat. You get to determine that. You put God to the test. God is not afraid. Let me tell you something. Real Christian faith always willing to challenge God. Because when Peter said, if it be you, we think that was. That was a challenge. When I said, I stand before the camera, and I said, not one of us will die like COVID-19. I don't. Listen. I went to proper school. Do proper studies. And get proper passes. Don't bring no reason to me. I am well experienced in these things. Are you with me? It is not anything I'm not aware of. You need to understand that I impress my reason. Glory to God. I understand the power of the world. And I understand that people who get the world to work for them are people who are willing to work the world. People who are willing to challenge God. Are you with me? Because I know my God. May God look back down from a challenge. Let me tell you, when you want God to work for you, when you do, you put it on me. Yeah, put it on me. When Peter stood up in that boat and he said, if it be you, bid me come. What do? He do that in public, not ashamed. He do that in lonely, not quiet. And he put it out so that Jesus Christ now is obligated, glory to God, to respond to the man said and move on his behalf. So when you put it out there, my friend, glory to God, loud. They say nothing, church. I'm concerned about what Corona doing. I'm more concerned about what God will can do. Amen. Let me tell you something. Corona is like a wave and in church. I have more faith in word than fear for waves. Corona is like the wave and the wind. It's aggressive. It's checking you so. But when you read this account, you get to understand the way you want. Glory to God. And it don't matter how aggressive, how violent, how threatening that the way of Corona might seem. Listen, Jesus Christ is the same. Hebrews 13 yesterday, today, and forever. What he did before he could do again. The way you want. I don't know about you. If you want to be like the Reverend, I want to be like the one, Peter. Not everybody in the boat who belong to Jesus going to get results, because every one of them, those 12, belong to Christ. But one was able to live above normal and natural. So just because you're locked in and you're in the church, glory to God, that don't mean that you're going to get the victory that takes. The victories that are available to you, you have to be willing to walk the way and see it work for you. You have to be willing to be courageous and trust God and not just believe but apply what you believe. Let me tell you as I close, let me tell you something. You might say, some people might hear me tell like that and say, hear me, hear me say, I ain't busy with Corona. You know what they come to the reckless. Well, listen, as I meditate on God yesterday, amen, in a split second, and I didn't take no time. One dog would go to God. You're right, listen, my God, I was waiting on the and then she didn't know where you as I conclude, glory to God, you hear God say, hey, let me tell you something, the same thing I was reckless too. Listen, once you start believing God, they take us under the money. People are weak, but people in the boat will see a direct lesson. Because when Peter said, if it be you, be me, come. And he just said, come, and he must tell them, do so. They step over. Well, boy, I can imagine every one of them in the men cringe and say, right, he got mad today. He went and say, sure, glory to God. Amen. Anytime you start really trusting God, prepare yourself for people to claim to label you as the reckless. But what I like about Peter is that listen, they call that, listen, thy faith, church. And sometimes, let me tell you something, sometimes the same way Jesus Christ hazarded himself and put himself in our way to rock our salvation, many times obedience to God involved taking risks, going beyond your human limit, doing things you have never done before, rebelling against natural laws. Understand the message in the message. We are not supposed to live by the laws of nature. We are called to be a supernatural people. And if everyone around you who don't know Christ falling by corona, the church ought to stand. You ain't saying nothing tonight, church. What I say, as God tell me to say, he told me to say, listen to me, faith in God that calls in you, this step out the boat, I'm not telling you, human reason will tell you, the boat's safer. Human reason will say, the boat's safer, we're going. What people don't understand still today is that the safest place to be is to be found doing what God says. So when Peter was on the boat, he was safer than the men in the boat because he was in the will of God. You could never be in God's will and drunk, church. Anytime you take your eyes off of God, then you put yourself in harm's way. You could never take a risk for Jesus and lose. No matter what it involves, going against the natural order of things. Once you continue to trust Jesus, you're going to stay afloat. And Jesus told me to tell you, this is not being reckless, you know. They will say you're reckless. This is not being careless. They will say you're careless. You know what Jesus told me? He said, this is being called being fearless. The word of the Lord tell you, Jesus, the word is about, and listen, Christians are called to have and to practice fearless faith. Somebody give God a praise in the house of God. Glory to you. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Fearless faith. Faith that is mixed with trepidation and extra and caution and tiptoeing and second guessing. It's not about being reckless or being careless, you know, or being rebellious, you know, or being foolish or unwise. Really and truly, it's about being fearless. Fearless faith is faith that hear what God say and apply what God say and faith that is found in obedience to God. I'm going to tell you something. When you are found in the act of obeying God, you are in the safest place. Go ahead and go on. I'm going to tell you something. I don't care if you saw me with you. No corona and no government. We can stick me up in your boat like a coward and feel like I just step out. Come on, stand there if you can stand there this morning. Yeah, I'm about to pray. Let me tell you something. Glory to God. Because let me tell you something. According to the they're trying to put a handcuff on you and restriction. Why? Because the language and the jargon is there. It's unsafe to come out. You have to stay in me. But if God say come, Jesus. Hey. Oh, God say come. Come on, Calvary Pentecostal. Oh, God say come. Yes. Come into God. Oh, God say come. And if God say come, I don't care how aggressive the wave is, the wind is, the sea is, whatever. If God say come. Well, then it is better to step out of the boat than to stay. Somebody talk to me tonight. Come on, let me hear somebody make a shout tonight. Somebody run like a lion tonight. Somebody come on, open. Come on, express your faith tonight. Do you feel good in the arm of your chest? Glory to God. Can you only want strength and victory in you? Like Paul told you. Scrap the gift in you. Somebody come on, open your mouth and say, Jesus, I will come. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah. Somebody give God a good prayer. I feel a joy in the Lord. Amen. I feel a strength in the Lord. Glory to God. Are you glad that you came in the house of God? I feel a strength in the Lord. The word is my boat. Somebody say the word is my boat. Hey, God, come God. The word is my boat. And I'm going to stay afloat. The word is my boat. And I refuse to sink. The word is my boat. I am moving to my Savior. And I am not afraid. Glory to God. But I will come and help us in prayer tonight. Glory to God. I will pray, but I will. That amen. Jesus Christ will keep us organizing my family to you. Jesus, our Savior. And the word that He has given us to change. That is what will protect us from corona. Don't care if corona mutates and if it grows stronger again, more violent, whatever. Jesus is what is going to keep us from sinking to corona, keep us afloat. And we pray that Jesus Christ continue to protect His church from corona. Jesus give us immunity from all disease. Glory to God. And we pray against us, that spirit of infirmity and declare death to every corona.